Students, welcome to Edurific. In this session, we shall use all our prior knowledge of the artist lab, such as commands, colors, and designs, to sketch a logo, a very popular logo. Have you ever observed the logo of Google Chrome? Can you recall? Don't worry. If you can't, here's a picture of the logo. So now, in this session, we shall be learning how to create this logo purely using the artist lab command. Shall we begin? Firstly, we shall know and analyze this logo. If you observe clearly, there are three concentric circles. A concentric circle is width when the circles have the same center. So there are three circles out here. The innermost circle, which is blue in color, the middle one, which is white in color, and the outermost circle, which has three partitions. That is, the circle is equally divided into three parts, having three different colors, which are red, green, and yellow. So basic mathematics is that a circle surrounds 360 degrees. So if you observe, the first circle, that is the innermost circle, which is in blue color, and the second circle, the middle circle, which is in white color, have no partitions, so they surround 360 degrees. But the outermost circle has got three partitions, which are equally divided, so each partition is 120 degrees. How do we do that? So 360 degrees divided by three equal partitions gives you 120 degrees. Alright, so now, since we have analyzed the logo well, we shall try to sketch the same logo using the artist in the artist lab. Shall we begin? So any thoughts of how we should be proceeding? So yes, we shall be proceeding from the outermost circle. So firstly, I shall be creating the red portion of the outermost circle. For this, I shall go to the brushes category, drag the set color command, assemble it in the scripting section. Now, what I'll be doing is, I will be making the artist draw the red portion or any portion in this logo by making the artist draw a line at a time. So the artist will draw a line, come back to the position, take a 1 degree turn, draw the second line, come back to the same position, take another line. So he'll be rotating line by line the whole of 360 degrees. We will see how this works. So firstly, for this, we shall be going to the actions category, drag the move forward command, and set to 100 pixels. So as you can see, the artist has moved forward. Now we shall make the artist move back again. By going to the actions category, dragging the same move forward command, but changing forward to backward and changing our pixel to 100. So we shall just be playing the run button and see what's happening in a slow mode. So the artist is moving forward and again coming back. Now, after the artist has come back, that is to the same position, we shall now be going to the actions category, dragging the turn left command, and changing it to 1 degree. That is, the artist will be moving just 1 degree. Now we shall reset and try to run it. So as you can see, we now attach a loop by placing the repeat loop just under set color and placing these commands out here. So now we shall click the run button and see what is happening. For this, we shall have to make it repeat 120 times since we are taking 1 degree each at a time. So we shall reset and click run. So as you can see, every line is being made with a 1 degree turn. So in that way, a whole red portion is being created. So if we will just speed up the process, you can see that the artist is turning 1 degree left, going forward, coming back, again turning 1 degree left, and that is how he is creating the whole of the red portion. This is what we will be doing with the other colors as well. As you can see, our red part is finished. Now we will be creating the green part. So for this, what do? We shall go to the brushes section. Before dragging the set color command, we'll be changing the color to green. And now dragging it and placing it in the scripting section. So now again, we shall be doing the same thing, that is going to actions category, dragging the move forward command, inserting the value of the pixels as 100. Now again, going to actions, dragging the move forward command, but instead changing it to backward. Inserting the value to be 100. This means that the artist moves forward, draws the green line, comes back to the same position. Now we'll be making him turn left by 1 degree. So for this again, we shall be going to actions category, drag the turn left command and add the value 1. So now we shall be putting all of this in the repeat loop. So for this we shall be going to the loop, dragging the repeat loop and placing under set color. And placing these commands under the repeat loop. So since again this is also a 1/3 partition of the outer circle, we shall be again inserting 120 degrees. As you can see, the green portion has now been made. Now we will be doing the same thing with yellow color. So for this again, we will go to the brushes section, set color to yellow, drag it underneath, follow the same command, that is go to action, drag the move forward command, enter the value as 100, again go to action, drag the move forward command, but instead change it to backwards and place the value as 100. Again go to action category, drag the turn left command and insert the value turn left by 1 degree. So this time it will be the same thing, but a yellow line will be done. So now we shall be putting all of this in the repeat loop for creating the one-third portion of the yellow part of the outer circle. So for this, since this also, that is the yellow color, occupies a one-third part, just like the green color and the red color, we should be putting 120 times, that is basically 120 degrees. So if you can see, the outer circle is thus created on the visualizing section. Now we shall focus on the middle circle, that is right circle. So for this, we shall go to brushes, set color to white, drag it, and again follow the same command, but instead this time we will be reducing the length. So for this, we shall again go to actions, drag the move forward command, change the units to 35, and now again go to action, drag the move forward command, change forward to backward, again change the pixel 35. So this means that we are creating a whole circle of white in color, which will overlap the outermost circle which we have created, as you can see. So before that, we shall be having to drag the turn left command, change the value of the degrees to 1 in the similar way, but since there are no partitions in this circle, we shall have to be taking the repeat loop for the whole of 360 degrees, because a circle surrounds 360 degrees. So we shall go to the loop category, drag the repeat command, assemble it in the script, place all the other commands inside the repeat loop. As we have discussed, since there are no partitions in the middle circle, which is white in color, it will be surrounding the whole of 360 degrees. As you can see, the artist has now drawn the middle circle. So the white color overlaps and thus is over the outermost circle, suppressing some parts of red, green and yellow portions. Now all we have to do is just create the innermost blue circle, which again will be done by the same procedure. So for this, again we shall go to brushes section, set color to blue, drag the set color command, place it underneath, go to actions, drag the move forward command. This time we will be reducing the distance to a little lower, up to 25 units. Now again, we are following the same procedure, that is, we will be asking the artist to draw a line by moving 25 pixels forward, coming back to the starting position, turning 1 degree left, and thus repeating these whole steps in creating a circle. So for this, again we shall be going to the actions category, dragging the move forward command, instead changing it to backward and changing the pixel again to 25 to get the artist back to the initial position. Now again going back to actions, dragging the turn left command and asking the artist to turn left after coming back to the initial position by 1 degree, ready to start the next line. So now we shall be adding all of this in the repeat loop. So since again this blue innermost circle has got no partitions and is a completely blue circle, we shall ask the artist to repeat the lines 360 times by placing the keys in the repeat loop. So now, as you can see, our group Google Chrome logo has thus been created. So we shall have to now click the run command to execute our code and visualize our logo. So on pressing the run command, you can see that the artist starts drawing the red part which is being highlighted. Each and every command which is being drawn in the visualizing section is being highlighted. So the artist is tilting 1 degree each time for every line. As you can see, now the red portion has almost finished and begin with the green portion where artist is going forward and coming backward but each time tilting 1 degree left for completing a whole circle. So if you add all the degrees made by red, green and yellow, it will sum up to 360 degrees. So as you can see, the green portion has now finished. And now the yellow portion is beginning to be sketched. Each command which is being followed on drawing in the visualizing section is being highlighted in the workspace. You can observe that for a clear understanding. So now the yellow portion sketching has begun. In a similar way, the artist is moving forward, coming back to the initial position and each time taking an extra 1 degree to complete the whole circle. Now if you can see, all the red and green parts have been completed now, including the yellow part which is about to be completed. So our outer circle is completed. And our middle circle, that is the white circle, has begun. So white circle overlaps, that is erases some part of the outer circle. Since there are no partitions in this circle, each circle is drawing a whole 360 degrees. So in the similar way, blue circle is created and thus the whole of the logo is created. So this is very easy, isn't it? Similarly, many such logos can be created just by sitting at home and giving instructions or commands to the computer using the code.org platform. I hope you have enjoyed the class and will try to create some other logos of your interest. Thank you.